Hi students, so till now we have learned how to file an application for registration of trademark. We have also learned about how to file and defend opposition proceedings when a trademark is pending registration. Now imagine a situation where an application is filed for registration of a trademark T time with capital T by a person A. Now B wants to oppose this trademark application because he thinks it is confusingly similar to his mark T time. The example of two marks are shown here. Unfortunately, B was unable to file TM5 within the statutory time limit of 4 months, and consequently the trademark T time is registered. So in these circumstances, whether B has any remedy, can he do anything when a conflicting trademark is registered? The answer is yes. The remedy available to B is called as rectification proceedings, and that's what we will discuss in this topic. This topic is divided into two lectures. In the first lecture, we will discuss about what is rectification of trademark, on what grounds a trademark can be rectified, and lastly, we will discuss the general procedure of rectification proceedings. In second lecture, we will discuss the procedure of rectification proceedings before the registrar and IPAB. So, what is rectification of trademark? Rectification means correction or alteration. Similarly, rectification of trademarks means applying for the rectification or removal of a registered mark from the register. Any person aggrieved by an entry wrongly made or wrongly remaining on the register of trademark is entitled to file a petition for cancellation of registration or rectification of the register for the removal of the registered mark. The grounds on which the registered trademark can be removed from the register has been narrowed down and restricted under the new Trademarks Act 1999. As compared to the grounds as were available under the old Act of 1958. These grounds are contained in Section 47, 57, 68 and 77 of the Act. Let's first discuss these provisions. Section 47 relates to removal of the mark due to non-use. Section 57 relates to cancellation or variation of the registration due to contravention of terms under which registration was granted. Section 68 relates to removal of collective marks. Section 77 relates to removal of certification trademarks. Section 68 and 77 are rarely used in real practice, and that's why in this lecture we will confine our discussion to removal of regular trademarks, that is, we will only discuss about Section 47 and 57 of the Trademarks Act. The next topic is grounds for rectification. It's always better to learn substantive law before you learn procedural law. That's why before we discuss the procedure under rectification proceedings, let's first discuss in detail the grounds on which a trademark can be rectified under Section 47 and 57 of the Trademarks Act. These mutually exclusive grounds can be divided into two categories. First is grounds under Section 47 and second is grounds under Section 57. Section 47 set out two distinct alternative grounds for removal of a mark from the register. The first ground requires that an applicant should satisfy the tribunal that the mark in question was registered without bona fide intention that it would be used in relation to the goods in respect of which it had been registered. And in addition, there has in fact been no bona fide use of the trademark in relation to those goods prior to the application for rectification. Under the second ground, the issue is somewhat different. The original intention of the registered proprietor is quite irrelevant, and the applicant has to merely show that for 5 years and 1 month immediately preceding the application, there has been no bona fide use of the mark in relation to the goods in respect of which it is registered. Unless the trademark is actually placed on the register, it cannot be a registered trademark. under section 47 subsection 1, the law has explicitly clarified that a continuous period of 5 years will start from the date on which the trademark is actually entered in the register. Under section 23, when a trademark is registered, it is registered as of the date of making the application, and the date is deemed to be the date of registration. The explicit provision made under section 47 mandates that the 5 year period will start from the date on which the trademark is actually entered in the register and not the date of application. This has cleared the ambiguity, as for all other purposes, the date of registration will be the date on which the application was filed. The next topic is how to prove non-use in a rectification proceeding. The first important point is non-use and abandonment of trademark are separate concepts, and non-use may or may not amount to abandonment. Let's now discuss how to establish non-use. There is a general rule in law that no man is bound to prove a negative. This rule is aptly applicable while proving non-use. In a rectification proceeding, the applicant must establish a prima facie case of non-use, and thereafter the onus shifts on the registered proprietor for proving that he or she has in fact used the mark. Now we will discuss the 5 grounds provided in section 57. First ground is the registered proprietor has committed contravention or failed to observe a condition entered in the register. For instance, at the time of registration, the registered proprietor were only permitted to sell the goods under the registered mark in relation to a fixed territory in India. But now they are selling the goods beyond that territory as well. The second ground is the register suffers from an absence or omission. For example, the mark should have been registered with a disclaimer or limitation. The third ground is the entry made in the register was made without sufficient cause. That is, registration was obtained by fraud or misrepresentation of facts. The fourth ground is the entered mark is wrongly remaining in the register. That is, registration is contrary to some provisions of the Act or is likely to cause confusion in the concerned public or trade, or the mark was not distinctive at the time of registration, etc. The fifth and last ground is there is an error or defect in any entry in register, like the renewal fee has not been paid. The next topic is general procedure of rectification of trademarks. Section 47 and 57 empowers the appellate board or the registrar to dispose of an application for rectification on specified grounds. The unique aspect of trademark rectification is, generally, it is optional for the applicant to file rectification application before the IPAB or the registrar. However, where in a suit for infringement of a registered trademark, the validity of registration is questioned, the issue as to the validity can be determined by appellate board. So, in such circumstances, an application for rectification has to be made only before the appellate board. With this, the lecture comes to an end. I hope you found this lecture useful. If you still have any doubts or queries about this lecture, please feel free to contact us on doubts@fusionlawschool.com. Hi viewers, to know more about us, please visit fusionlawschool.com, or you can also visit us on Facebook, Twitter or Google+. Links are provided here. To stay updated, subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button. If you like this video, please like, share and comment down below.